Hi, my beautiful people, how are you today? We are yet back again, and this time round we are trying to know about something different today, and this is categorized as RAS. What are RAS? RAS simply stands for Real World Assets. What are these real world assets, the RAS? By definition, real world assets represent some of the most compelling uses of the blockchain and its ability to tokenize various items of value, whether physical, digital, database, from art and collectibles to real estate, stocks and commodities and personal data. Various tangible and intangible assets can now be represented digitally on chain through the issuance of tokens representing the RAS. Real-world assets unlock a novel means of transferring ownership, sharing revenues, streams, and increasing liquidity for assets that were previously liquid or non-commercial. Tokenization holds great potential to transform traditional assets classes and financial markets. In other words, what we are seeing here is that with these assets, things like, for example, in the country where I originally come from, I'm born and raised in Uganda, and in that country, people are able to own land. Someone can buy his own land and they own land titles. So with this perspective, someone can make his land title or her land title into a token. He can tokenize it. So we can give an example. There are a lot of tokens which have really presented themselves as RAS. One of them that we have is the Ondo Finance. It's a token. I think if you go to read about it, right now, I think we can see its value. Let's try to see its value. I think this token has risen already in value. Ondo Finance. Let's try to see Ondo. Yes, it's right now $0.91 at this very moment, and this is an example. So what does even this token do? If we go back here, they tell us that Ondo Finance has been gaining significant and consistent traction, supported by its TVL growth, as shown below. As of writing, Ondo Finance TVL approximate at 163.35 million US dollars, and it is the second largest RUA protocol after ST USDT. It is backed by Finance. It's a financial token. There is also MakerDAO. I think we're going to be brief a little bit. Many people who are in the space already know MakerDAO, what it does. MakerDAO has been one of the most active protocols working on integrating real-world assets into their operations. Recently, it was revealed that the estimated 80% of free revenue earned by MakerDAO was generated from the real-world assets. With such a strong cash flow supporting its treasury, this is a highly beneficial for MakerDAO, given that the core product of the protocol is DAI. So it is a decentralized protocol. So we are seeing a lot of traction with the RAS. Now, what someone has to do is to go and scout all those tokens they think that have been underrated and they are not paid attention to. And you do more research on them before you add them on your portfolio. We have the credit coin, which is CTC, which is also a ROA. I'm not going to go deep in them because of time. Maple Finance, and is also one of them. Goldfinch, GFI, is also one of them. Do your research. We have Centrifuge, which is also one of them. So there are like five of them they mention here. My point is, do your own research on these type of assets, and you'll see that at least you'll not be left behind when this coming bull run is really heated. So thank you so much. I'm not going to talk much today, but at least I've brought you a concept that many are not paying attention to. Real world assets, in abbreviation RAS. Thank you so much.